We reached a turning point in our civilization. A few thousand years ago, we were only hunter-gatherers, trying our best to survive and not become extinct. Today, we've created an entire virtual replica of the world, solved many of the world's problems, and sent humans into outer space. Looking at our exponential progress, it leaves us with a puzzling question. Where do we go from here? Do we find ourselves blazing through the galaxies and colonizing them? Or are we destined to be stuck on Earth, with conditions worsening over the coming decades? In this video, we will explore this topic and see what would happen if we fast forward centuries into the future. As a civilization grows larger and becomes more advanced, its energy demands will increase rapidly, mainly due to its population growth and the energy requirements of its various machines. With this in mind, the Kardashev scale was developed as a way of measuring the technological advancement of one civilization. The scale is based on how much usable energy it has at its disposal. It was originally designed in 1964 by a Russian astrophysicist, Nikolai Kardashev. At the time, it was used to look for signs of extraterrestrial life within cosmic signals. Then, Carl Sagan divided this classification even further, each with an energy disposal level. Type 1 civilization with 10 to the 16th watt of energy, Type 2 with 10 to the 26th, and Type 3 with 10 to the 36th. Along the same line, Carl Sagan also formulated an equation to compute at what year the civilization on Earth would accomplish a specific class. Assuming a 4% annual growth, it is estimated that we'll achieve class 1 in this year, approximately in 119 years. Class 2 and class 3 will be achieved in the following years. In the next part of the video, we'll sit in our hypothetical time machine and go forward a few centuries into the future. About two decades from now, scientists at the Human Brain Project will have successfully mapped the entire human brain. It is the very synapses and axonal connections. This feat will have huge implications, specifically by unlocking the mysteries of the most complex and elusive object in the human body. Entirely new branches of medicine and technology open up. For decades after that, people can now attach an exocortex, a technology where the human brain can connect to a brain implant, a merger of biological intelligence and machine intelligence. A human with cognitive skills and neuroprocessing powers, far exceeding than that of a normal human. People can now easily connect with the internet inside their brains, accessing all the accumulated knowledge of the web. The true altruistic and benevolent race of humans now inherit the world. But just when you think that it sounds too much like science fiction, well, Elon Musk even said that humans must become cyborgs if they are to stay relevant in the future, especially a future that is dominated by AI. In just about 1.5 decades after that, cyborg brain technology has magnified research by massive amounts, specifically in the nanotech area. Nanites, or nanorobots, will be invented. They can be injected into the bloodstream and can give out real-time readings of the human body. Also, they can increase telomere length and prevent free radical damage to the point that we almost reverse age. Humans could routinely live up to 200 years or more. As we fast forward through the different timelines in the future, I want to take you back to our present timeline in 2022, to the time of writing this video script. You see, every time I need to come up with different video scripts, I first need to grasp the key ideas from a particular topic. That would mean reading a lot of articles and books that are relevant. Sometimes it's difficult to find time to read all of them, especially when we're in a rush to produce more videos. But thanks to Blinkist, I now have access to valuable knowledge and great ideas quickly. Blinkist is an app that allows you to read the best selection of nonfiction books in 15 minutes. You can either read the book or you can either get it read to you, just like an audiobook. Right now, I'm currently immersing the blinks from the book Until the End of Time by Brian Greene. A while ago, I read the full-length original copy of the book. But with this app, it is a refresher course for me. It helps me to rejuvenate those main themes and plots that are densely foggy in my brain. If you're like me who read a lot of books per year, most likely you have forgotten a lot of information. This app, it will help you to regain the concepts and ideas again. Quincas is currently running a special offer. You'll get a 7-day free trial and a 25% off for a premium membership. That way you'll be able to understand powerful ideas and discover the beauty of the world around you. So don't miss out by clicking the link in the video description below. Okay, now let's jump back to our time machine and go forward to the next stop. By this time, according to the previously shown equation, humankind will achieve the level of Type 1 civilization. We would be able to harness all the Earth's energy and have control over all natural forces. We would be able to control volcanoes, the weather, or even earthquakes. Some of you may even hear the news recently about using machine learning to detect earthquakes. From detection to controlling. That might be a long-winded process, but at least humankind has 1.5 centuries to do so. Around this time, nanites are used to upload the human consciousness into computers. This would essentially mean that now humans could live on in computers. Physical bodies are now obsolete. Humankind would live on as electromagnetic vibrations of consciousness in quantum processors. The entire consciousness is now encoded into the quantum machines. Perhaps this is our way to reach technological singularity. Our physical bodies will not be limited to the ultimate fate of the universe. Maybe this is a way to make our human timescales comparable to the universe timescales. At this time, it is estimated that we'll be reaching the Type 2 civilization level. Not only that we'd be harnessing the power of our sun, but also controlling it. The most popular method is the hypothetical Dyson sphere. It would encompass every single inch of the sun, gathering most of its energy output and transferring it to our planet for later use. Nothing known to science could wipe out a Type 2 civilization. Let's say a moon-sized object enters our solar system and is on a collision course with our planet. As a Type 2 civilization, we have the ability to completely vaporize it out of existence. So to conclude, we'd harbor enough disposable energy to essentially make our civilization immune to extinction. Entering the realm of nanites and consciousness again. During this time, nanites can build synthetic bodies, into which our consciousness can again be downloaded. This would certainly mean that humans are now immortal. We can now start spreading into other galaxies and star systems without needing to have a faltering physical body to take care of. Our consciousness can simply be encoded into a data signal and beamed into small starships across interstellar space. Sail ships with consciousness encoded in its database. This whole scenario seems like a plausible solution to eternal intergalactic space travel. Finally, we arrive at the end of our timeline in this video, reaching the Type 3 civilization. At this stage, we would become galactic travelers, with knowledge of everything having to do with energy. Also, we would have developed colonies of robots that are capable of self-replication. Their population may increase into the millions as they spread out across the galaxy, helping us in our mission to colonize stars after stars. But stretching over the galaxies in such a manner would encounter some problems. The species would be constrained by the laws of physics, specifically light-speed travel. Unless, of course, we develop a warp drive technology, another thought-provoking topic to be discussed in a future episode. Just stay tuned for that. Despite all the possible alternative timelines in our technological development, it is important to develop a realistic model of futuristic thought. Because if anything has brought us together during the pandemic, it's our feeling of uncertainty about the future. Now we know that urgent action is needed to change humanity's course in all aspects of life, saving the planet from utter disruptions. As theoretical physicist Michio Kaku said, the next 100 years of science will determine whether we perish or thrive. Will we remain a Type 0 civilization? Or will we advance and make our way into the stars? Only time will tell.